Chimoya. We are far from the sacred places of our grandfathers. We are far from the bones of my people. But I ask on this day of sorrow and uncertainty that the wisdom of my father find me and help me understand my dilemma. Speak to me, Father. Speak to me in my dreams.
I've never seen you so troubled, Chakotay.
I have a son, Father.
A son, Chakotay? Oh. This is the reason for your despair. Was he born with two arms? And two legs? And a heart that beats?
Yes, but...
Then it's a cause for celebration. You will make a fine father. You needn't worry.
I'm not sure I'm willing to be a father to him.
Not willing?
He was born without my consent. I had no part in it.
No part in it? It's been a long time, so forgive me, but it seems that I had to play a part before your mother could conceive.
My DNA was taken from me, used by a woman to impregnate herself without my permission.
I see. You're trying to decide whether you should accept the child in your heart.
It's more than that.
But it must begin with that.
How do you take a child into your heart who is forced upon you by a mother's deception?
He knows nothing of deception. He is innocent. Centuries ago, when the women of our tribe were raped by white conquerors, many gave birth to their children, and we did not reject them. They were accepted by the tribe. One was a direct ancestor of ours, Chakotay. His name was Se'aktor. He became a great leader of our people. Here is a man who was given life without his mother's consent. Are you so different from her? And is your child so different from Se'aktor?
No.
He is your son, Chakotay. And he is a child of our people.